Oh hey, welcome back to my channel. So today I have an updated what is in my bag for you guys. Now I haven't done one of these for a while. The last time I did one was actually a collaboration with Arielle, and that was on her channel, and the bag that featured in that of mine was actually much smaller than the one that I'm going to share with you guys today. So let's cut to the chase. The bag that I'm going to dive into is my Hermes Kelly bag. Possibly my favourite, if not one of my favourite handbags. And this actually was a hand-me-down. It belonged to my mama. It is vintage, therefore, and it's got a lot of wear and tear, but I love this bag to the high heavens, and I use it a lot, so that is why. And so shall we dive into it? I think we should. The first item, funnily enough, used to also belong to Mama Filthy. It's an Hermes wallet. I believe it's the Constance wallet. I could be very wrong, so I will link it down below to clarify. But I love this wallet, not just because it matches, but it fits all of my stuff. So I have quite an abundance of loyalty cards. I am quite the loyalty card hoarder, although I do tend to think that I'm just being smart because when you get rewards and stuff, it's great. So anyway, aside from the wallet, what else is in here? I have my trusty gloves, which featured in my latest haul video. They are from Zara, and I referenced them as little acne jackets for your hands because they are very similar to the Shearling acne jackets. But I love them so much because I am an iPhone user, and so they keep my fingers warm, they look cool, but also they allow me to use my phone. So love those gloves. In my bag, I also have my vlogging camera. Now, if you guys watch my Vlogtober videos, this is the camera that I used, and I got this back in Miami from Best Buy. I don't know why I referenced where I got it, but it's the Sony A5000, and I love it because it has the flip-up screen, and so that allows you to vlog and see what you're vlogging. But also it has a removable lens, which is a great option to have. Personally, I think this lens is great for what I use it for. But yeah, as you can see, I attempted to tape down the clips, but one has set free, so I'm gonna have to tape that down again. Or just remove it. Anyway, also in my handbag, I have a pair of sunglasses. Now, wishful thinking really, because there's not that much sun in London, although it has been a little bit sunny today, and it can be quite sunny on the colder days, but yeah. I tend to just be one of those people that likes to just shield my face from the public, especially if I'm not wearing makeup. So in my bag, in this really cool case, are my Phillip Lim Times, or four Linda Farrow sunglasses, which I love so much. They're just so cool. And they go with my hair, oh my God. I just noticed. Anyway, I will link those down below. I got them from Selfridges and they were £180, which I think for designer sunglasses is pretty reasonable. That's around Ray-Ban Aviator price, because they can tend to be like £300, like Chanel and Prada. So love those. Also in my Hermes Kelly bag, I have my business cards, which I could share with you guys. I'll just show. So as I'm sure you know, well, I'd like to think you know if you follow me on Twitter and whatnot, my handle is Fashion Filth. So I wanted my card to have like a fashionable Baroque decaying like wall on it. Yeah, so anyway, obviously it's got my deets on the other side, but don't want to be sharing that with the internet. So yeah, I got them from moo.com, I believe. So if you guys are, yes it is, so if you guys are looking for business cards, then moo.com is a great place to get them. What else, what else, what else? I have my Oyster card in my bag. Even though I don't take public transportation that much, it's always handy to have it just in case. And those of you who are like, what the hell is an Oyster card? It's basically like a top-up, pay-as-you-go, basically just said the same word, travel card. So you can take the bus and the train within London, and you put the money on this, and yeah, it's like a little access card to the underground. What else do I have? My makeup bag. Shall we dive into my makeup bag? Let's, I think we should. So my makeup bag is, gosh, it's from Paul and Joe, and my mum got it for me ages ago, and it is literally like the Mary Poppins makeup bag in the sense that you can fit so much stuff in there. So I have a Compeed blister pad, because that is vital when you are wearing shoes that may give you blisters and you don't know when that might be. So Compeed blister pads are a must for me. I have my Bare Minerals block powder, which is close to death, And I'm happy to say I have another one in my makeup room. I bought an extra one when I was in Miami because I knew that this was happening. Love that stuff though. I have a variety of testers because I feel that they are ideal for on-the-go makeup bags. So I have the Buxom tester, really good mascara, although I bought the full-sized one and I'm convinced that they make the testers better than the full-sized ones so that you go and buy it. But yeah, that's just my theory. Because this is really, really good, but for some reason I feel like the full-sized one isn't as great. Anyway, just a thought. I have a little Benefit What's Up highlighter, which is super handy. It's like a little chapstick, but a highlighter, so that's great to keep in my makeup bag. I have a little shop-style mirror. I also have a Benefit They Are Real mascara tester, good mascara. Black stuff just fell. I also have a primer mascara tester by Lancome, and basically this is what I apply religiously before I put my mascara on. So if I have had to leave the house without putting my mascara on, then I'm glad to have this because I can go ahead and do it on the go. I also have a variety of lip balms, may I just say. I have two Carez lip balms. All of this fits in the makeup bag, I'm not even joking. I have it in Plum and I also have it in Wild Rose. Love these, and they're great for winter time because they give you a little bit of like a rosy tint to your lips, but they also shield you from the cold and that chappage, which we don't like. No chappage, no. So yeah, what else do I have? I have this perfume oil that I got from Whole Foods in America. It smells so good, and I think I mentioned this, it's called Moonlight. It's really hard to describe what Moonlight smells like, but it's really nice, and I will try to link it, although I feel like that'll be impossible. But perfume oils are great because they tend to last a lot longer than just regular perfumes, and they're a lot more affordable, so definitely worth checking them out. I have another lip balm. It's the Aesop Rosehip Seed Lip Balm, or lip cream. So good, like seriously, words cannot describe how good this stuff is. It seems to like evaporate, not evaporate, but like really just melt into your lips and then disappear, which is quite nice because I feel like it's just being absorbed and working. And yeah, I've got that in Miami too, but I'm sure any Aesop will stock it, and it's really good. So moving on to some lip products, I have a Kevin Aucoin Relentless lipstick in my makeup bag, which is a really nice pink color, quite natural. Now my favorite colors that I've been wearing a lot of, and you guys have asked me loads in previous videos, like what is it? So I'm actually wearing it today. It's a combo of the Makeup Forever Aqua Lip in 3C. And I also got a little tester when I was in Sephora, which is amazing because I can keep that in my makeup bag, but I also have the full-sized one in my makeup bag, so yeah. I use this to line. Sometimes I apply it all over my lip. In the Instagram picture from the motel party where I was going with the glasses on, this is what I was wearing. So yeah, it's Aqualip 3C. And today I used that to line my lips, and then I used a lipstick, and that is NARS Tonkin, which has to be my favorite matte lipstick of the moment. So is that all that's left? No, we have two more items in my makeup bag. One is a pair of teeth or a clip. My mom's always called them teeth. I don't know if anybody else calls them teeth, but if you do, like, let me know because that's quite funny. But yeah, a hair clip. Ow. And I also have this cool contraption that I won at Universal Studios in our hotel, in the hotel arcade. Yeah, it's actually a bag clip. So what you would do is, it looks like this, and you would put this part on the table, and somehow it just works. Gravity is on its side. I wouldn't have thought that a heavy handbag or a heavy shopping bag would stay, but it does. And so you put that on the table, and then this is the clip where you would clip your handbag or your shopping bag, and it just works. So yeah. Do we have anything else in my handbag? We do. I have a little notebook because if I come up with some YouTube ideas, or if I want to write some stuff down on the go, or if I need to remember something, then this is with me. But also, I usually have a little weekly planner diary on me, but I left that in the States stupidly, and so it's really awkward time because it's coming up for the new year, so there's no point me buying a 2014 one literally just for December, or November and December. So I've bought myself a 2015 one, and I am excited to get to using it because this isn't ideal when there's no dates. But anyway, that is what is in my Hermes Kelly bag. Look, it's empty aside from some junk, and my Miami house key for some reason which is of not much use to me here in London, but yeah. So that is what was in my bag. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I really would love to know what you would like to see me film in the next few videos, because I have some ideas, but it's always good to know what you guys want to see. So let me know, and I will see you in my next one. Mwah, love you lots, bye. Oh hey, welcome back to my channel. Now I'm just gonna really seriously cut to the chase, because it's a haul, as you've seen, and I have like mountains of, okay, not mountains, but heaps of things around me, and that I have collected, I swear, like over the last month, and I want to share it with you. So I'm gonna start with the palm to my left. Now, or actually I'm gonna start with the hat on my head while I remember, otherwise I will forget. So the hat on my head is new.